Let's take a look at more ground reports sent by India Today colleagues.
Agnimitra Paul has been detained. She's been taken by the police. She's been taken at detention. You're being detained by the police. What is...
Resignation of Mamata Banerjee.
The one and only demand that the BJP makes here, that they want nothing less than Mamata Banerjee's resignation. We see that Agnimitra Paul is being taken by the police. She's been detained right now, taken straight to the buses that are awaiting them. They're going to be detained, taken to the police station. As scores of the BJP protesters have breached barricade, this is their show of strength. A clear message by the BJP that they are shutting stop of nothing. The BJP there has breached the barricades. They've barged across, headed towards the health ministry. We're looking at the main leaders leading it. Agnimitra Paul has been detained by the police. She's taken in straight to the police, towards the police station. And these are the other members of the BJP holding placards and banners, walking straight towards the health ministry. Our demand, what is
it? Mamata Banerjee should resign.
Is that as simple?
Yes. She has failed as a health minister, she has failed as a home minister, and she has failed as a chief minister, because she is a part of the connivance, the whole thing which has happened in Anjikar Medical College.
Why do you say that she's connived with the...
Yes, because the doctor, the principal there, he has been under shelter of Mamata Banerjee. Why?
He's under her shelter, you believe?
Yes.
And what about the ex-principal Sandeep Ghosh? There's a lot of
things people are asking. Even we are also asking that there are a lot of anomalies in the whole process of investigation which was done by the police. The first 3 days, every moment has been spent to hush up and destroy the evidences. It's very evident now.
Why do you think this has happened? The CBI gave a report that said it's not a case of gang rape. How would you look at that? Are you satisfied with it?
I haven't seen the report. I'm still here. But I must say that the kind of fluid which is found in a lady's body, the kind of body marks which are found in a lady's body, it is not possible to do everything by one person.
We're looking at the BJP's rally that's been stopped short right here on the street in the middle of the road. They've blocked it off. And we're seeing brute force being used by the protesters to push barricades down to move towards the health ministry. We're seeing these protesters that's led by Sukanta Mazumdar. We're also seeing Suvendu Adhikari, Agnimitra Paul, Lokit Chatterjee, Rupa Ganguly, who are protesting and leading these protests. Scores of BJP protesters right behind them as they're trying to push off barricades and move ahead towards the health ministry. The situation is getting chaotic despite the police presence here. We could very well see violence that can pan out. And here we see barricades that have been broken. There are protesters who have just jumped over. They've just jumped over the barricades. The protesters are running amok. We're looking at huge chaos there. Huge chaos as protesters have broken barricades. They've breached security. They've just broken barricades and just come towards the health ministry area. Despite massive police deployment, we're looking at protesters there jumping past those barricades. And these protests here are led by Lokit Chatterjee. Agnimitra Paul has been detained. She's been taken over by the police. Agnimitra Paul has been taken over by the police.
So that was a ground report sent in by my colleague Nabila. Nabila is joining us live now from Kolkata. Nabila, what happened? What do you see around you? You're in thick of action. What is the situation right now? Nabila, yes. Go ahead. There appears to be... Yes. Nabila, just check your microphone once again, and if you can hear me, we have these visuals of the protest earlier that was sent in. Some of these leaders have now been detained by the Kolkata police. Yes, Nabila, if you can hear me, go ahead, please. Right, so these are the visuals. Look at that. Protesters jumping over the barricades. And this is right before what happened when the police detained angry protesters. But this is also a political showdown, remember, because it is the opposition, Bharatiya Janata Party in Bengal, that's trying to amp up pressure at the Mamata government for the delay, for the charges that the man in question, beyond the accused, is well connected. Nabila, yes, if you can hear me, go ahead.
Pooja, I was showing you that the protests have just ended. So all the BJP workers are on their way back home with their flags. It was a protest march that was organized by the BJP's state unit here in West Bengal, Sukanta Majumdar, Agnimitra Paul, who were leading it.
Nabila continues to show us the visuals on the screen. This also is reflective of heightened tensions. Remember, it's not just about politics. There is visible anger, specifically in Kolkata, because this is as much about the city that people of Kolkata take pride in. And to know that this has happened to a woman doctor and inside the hospital. It's an extremely scary situation, and that's the reason you see anger pouring out on the streets, whether it's doctors, whether it's politicians, whether it's in general the citizens of the country who have come ahead. Whether there will be some change, whether there will be an example set that nothing of this sort will ever happen again in any city of the country. The Kolkata hospital horror investigation, meanwhile, intensifies. The CBI sources have revealed to India Today that the case may not be of a gang rape, because the DNA evidence for now confirms that the man you're looking at on your screen, and what less than you call him as a monster, that he was the one who allegedly raped and murdered the woman. While Sanjay Roy has been taken in custody of the Kolkata police, the possibility of more individuals being involved has not been ruled out. Sources within CBI revealing significant lapses on the part of hospital's former principal Dr. Sandeep Ghosh. One, failed to protect and barricade the crime scene right away. Delay in getting the FIR filed, which is responsibility of the hospital administration. And third, even revealed the victim's identity, and that's why Kolkata police also is questioning him. CBI claims that the evidence collected by them suggests that the crime scene was altered. And that's a big update. Remember, with the ongoing renovations that were going near to the crime scene, the area not completely barricaded also has come under intense scrutiny. So while the CBI questions Sandeep Ghosh for the seventh consecutive day, forensic experts are also examining the vehicle he used to trace movements. In response to rising tensions, CISF has taken over the security of the RG Corps Medical College and Hospital to maintain law and order, especially after the vandalism.
As we see, the CISF has just arrived at the RG Corps Hospital. This was based on the Supreme Court's orders. And of course, the Home Ministry then following up on this. The CISF have just arrived. There are two battalions who have just arrived in those two buses there. The buses are standing right outside where the CISF have been brought. They've arrived. You see many lady officers who are also part of it. Several lady officers who are part of it, as we're looking at female doctors who have been protesting. So a huge number of officers have just landed at the RG Corps Hospital. Remember, this comes in light of the vandalism that happened right on the eve of Independence Day, which the Supreme Court took strong objection to, asking why there wasn't proper arrangement of security staff at that point. Now we're looking at an after effect of that vandalism. Huge security forces that have been deployed right here. That was followed up by the Central Home Ministry as well. Today we hear revelations coming in from the CBI, as they've put out some really strong details of vandalism and attempt to, in fact, meddle with evidence. That's what the CBI says. This is exactly where the rape and murder of that young girl happened, the doctor, and the third floor of this building. And where, when the vandalism happened, the protesters came exactly from here, this area here where I'm standing at. They walked in from the gate here, rushed straight in towards the emergency ward, vandalized the emergency ward and areas around here. Now, this the CBI also suspect could be an attempt to tamper with evidence. That's what the CBI says in its report. It's clear something was, they were trying to cover up on some lines, and the family was told it was suicide. There was a bit to cover up. and this is precisely where the vandalism happened, that it could have been a deliberate attempt to tamper and meddle with evidence. Report by the CBI in the Supreme Court suggesting just that. And while in the backdrop of those developments in the top court, we're looking at huge security forces deployed right here at RG Car 2 weeks after the rape and murder of the young trainee doctor. With camera person Pavan, this is Nabila Jamal for India Today, Kolkata.